going on, my super sandwiches? Rhymestyle here, and today I bring some amazing news in regards to Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle. We have a brand new LR. It's that time again. Nano, you watch this video? You probably not watch this video because you're probably recording your own video. But it's time. I challenge you to another LR duel war of who can get LR cell first. But knowing you, you're probably getting your first single summon, so this might be a short-lived war as always, but whatever. Comment section below, who's going to pull the LR cell first, me or Nano? Let me know down below what you guys think. So, what does he do? Well, before I start, in the description below, I'm going to have a link to the subreddit, as always. If you want to see the translations or any further questions as far as team composition and stuff like that, you can ask that over here. But for now, let's go over the actual information on the card. By the way, also, tomorrow I have a video going live on me doing some spicy summon, which you'll actually have fun watching that video. In that video, I mentioned that LR cell didn't get announced yet, and if you wonder why, it's because I recorded that video earlier today, and this is like hours later, so that's why. But even in that video, I mentioned that LR cell might be announced by the time that video goes live, so in case you're wondering, that's why. But what does he do? LR cell, he is the extreme physical type leader, which will give you plus 4 ki, and it'll boost your attack, HP, and defense by 100%. If you have any good guys in your team or super units, then you only get plus 2 ki and get a 70% boost to HP, attack, and defense. Again, I don't really know anybody that still runs mono units unless you do stuff like Super Battle Road. But category is the way to go. If you're not running Super Battle Road, category is the way to go. But even then, they have a category version of Super Battle Road as well. So I feel like running the mono skills, leader skills, is kind of outdated at this point. But again, one of you guys might be out there that are really excited about running only single units, in which case, I guess he is a pretty viable option as an extreme physical leader. His super attack, this is A1. His super attack, his 12 key attack, which is very easily achievable, by the way. His 12 key attack is going to deal colossal damage to all enemies. He's an AoE unit. Remember Broly? Yeah, Broly was so 5 minutes ago. It's all about Perfect Cell now. And not only that, but you also recover HP by 10%. 10%, not 5. 10%. So every time you do that super attack, you get health back. A1. His 18 key attack attacks only one person. It's called the Violence Disaster, and it raises attack for one turn and deals mega colossal damage to the enemy. So, similar to what we saw with Agility Majin Vegeta on the original LRs, his 12 key attack is based on attacking everything on the screen, whereas his 18 key attack is based on attacking one. So, great unit. His passive is so dope. His passive is called Full Body Nightmares, and it says attack and defense boost by 90% at the start of the turn, and then for every enemy present, he gets plus 1 key and attack boosted by 10%. So this guy literally is built for the World Tournament, which, I mean, I guess kind of makes sense because they are doing a World Tournament very, very soon. So they're releasing this to kind of like get up to that point. So if you get this guy prior to the next World Tournament, he's going to be your best friend. And not only that, but if you go into any other events where basically you have to deal with multiple units or even, you know how they have those like certain stages where like when you fight, for example, Cooler, it'll have like Cooler squadron of 3 people. Like, again, when there's 3 people on the screen, he gets plus 3 key and then a 30% attack boost. So this is actually really, really good. I'm actually very impressed with what they did with Cell, because, like, the last couple of LRs with outside from Bardock have been kind of like, meh. I mean, the free-to-play LRs are always kind of, like, questionable. They're great supporters most of the time. But, like, I feel like Beerus specifically kind of got shafted when it came down to, like, how good he could have been. But this is how you do an LR. Attack animation is great, the card art is beautiful, and the passive and super attack is just literally spot on. Like, Akatsuki, you guys have done yourself with this one. His links consist of Messenger of the Future, Gentleman, Shock and Speed, Big Bad Bosses, Legendary Power, Ultimate Life Form, and Fierce Battle, and of course, he fits under the Android category. So if you got lucky enough to pull Android 21 in the past banner, this guy is going to be amazing on it. I mean, just like how we talked about it in the video last week when me and Nana were discussing that, you know, Android 21 was coming to the game. We mentioned that if LR Cell comes out, he's going to be perfect with this. And again, they made LR Cell an actual LR in this, and I'm super happy about it. By the way, again, if you didn't get the hints, he is going to be summonable, and the banner should be live in the next day or so. So good luck to everybody out there. And again, in the comment section below, who you think is going to pull the card first, me or Nano? Basically, let's see what you guys stand for. Keep eye open for the dual summons at some point over the course of the next couple weeks or so, because I know Nano's actually traveling this week and he won't be back until like later this weekend. So we'll see if we have enough time to actually record a dual summon prior to that. But if not, expect it next week or so. But I know I am at least summoning this week, so keep your eye open for that. So with that said, what do you guys think about LR Cell? Yay or nay? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And again, at any point, if you have any questions in regards to team compositions or overall thoughts about the cards, I will have the description to, or the link to the subreddit in the description below, so check that out as well. But wait, there's more! I've turned into an infomercial now. But wait, there's more. We actually have two more units that are also being released, which are actually part of the World Tournament. We got Great Saiyan Man Super Saiyan 2 Adult Gohan, and, well, I guess Great Saiyan Man Super Saiyan, same thing. Adult Gohan, basically, in Great Saiyan Man outfit, whatever you want to call him. And then we have Final Form Cooler, which is kind of weird and odd. He doesn't really fit in, you know, the whole Cell arc. Well, I guess it's not really Cell arc, because Great Saiyan Man's after Cell arc, but whatever. You're getting Great Saiyan Man and you're getting Final Form Cooler if you participate in a World Tournament, if you get high enough in the rankings. Now, personally, I don't know if I'm going to go that far for both of these cards, just because I know how exhausting these world tournaments get, but we'll see how the schedule works out. What does he do? Well, the lead ability for the Great Saiyaman is strength types get plus 2 ki, and his HP attack defense is going to get boosted by 50%, which is not that great. And I feel like at this point, Akatsuki should understand that you can't really do anything with that leader skill. I mean, I guess if you run that leader and then run like a good leader, maybe from like the friend list, sure. But for the most part, this doesn't do that much. So I feel like Akatsuki, what they should start doing is implementing leader skills that actually make sense, because this one's kind of whack. But then again, he's built to be more of a support unit, so you don't really want to run him as a leader anyways. So I kind of understand. And Super Attack is the Super Kamehameha, which greatly raises attack for one turn and deals supreme damage to the enemy, one enemy. Unlike Cell, he only attacks once, similar to every other unit in the game. His passive is actually on, it's amazing. His passive is called Jointly Opposed Strength, and Super Class allies get plus 2 ki. Attack and defense boost to 30%, and Extreme Class enemies, so basically all bad guys you come across, lose 50% defense, which is actually really, really good. His links consist of Golden Warrior, Super Saiyan, Shock and Speed, Hero Justice, Prepare for Battle, and Kamehameha. And the categories it fits under are Hybrid Saiyans, World Tournament, and the Majin Buu Saga. So, really good unit. Like, if there's one card you want to go for in a World Tournament, this is definitely it. I mean, this is the one thing that makes you really want to, like, grind in the next World Tournament. But at the same time, again, I know how heavy those grinds get, so I don't know. Are you going to grind for it? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And again, also want to toss this question out there. Which card do you like better between Great Saiyaman and Final Form Cooler? Let me know down below as well. Cooler, what does he do? Well, Cooler is kind of odd. His leader skill is actually very, very unique. I don't know if I've seen this ever before, but strength type enemies lose attack and defense by 40%. I mean, I don't know why you want to run a leader skill that doesn't boost your HP, attack, and defense. You're literally going to jump into these events that have, like, that'll give you, like, 60,000 HP max, and you won't be able to do that much damage. But at the same time, I guess, you are reducing your opponent's attack and defense by 40%, so you're able to tank, but I feel like it's so outdated, it probably would have worked 3 years ago, but I don't know how well that works today. But I don't know, that's his leader skill. Actually, I wonder how well that would work in Super Battle Road. I feel like it would be really, really painful, because end of the day, the bosses will still have like millions of HP and you'll do like no damage, so you'll probably take like 2 hours to beat one Super Battle Road. But I don't know, what do you guys think about that? What even is the point of having a leader skill like that? Give me your thoughts down below. His super attack consists of the Supernova, which we've seen before. It deals supreme damage to the enemy and greatly lowers defense. I'm sure, again, we've seen that ability as well. And his passive is actually very interesting. Thoroughly enforced aggression, agility types attack and defense plus 40%, and a high chance to perform two additional attacks. Each attack raises your attack by 5%, maxing out 50%. So I don't know how great he is. I feel like he's supposed to be like an offensive support unit, but like you have so many other better options. And to me, honestly, I might be wrong at this, I'm just looking at this on paper. To me, he doesn't seem like a great, valid choice to run as a support unit. I mean, again, maybe the leader skill might be kind of interesting to test out against events, but like the thing is yeah, you'll be able to reduce your opponent's HP attack, attack defense by 40%. If it actually had a leader ability of reducing HP attack and defense by 40%, that would be kind of A1, because if you run double cooler leader, for example, then you're like literally jumping into the battle and reducing your opponent's HP attack and defense by 80%. Which might make it kind of foul, but at the same time, you're not doing that. So, like, reducing attack and defense by 40%, and if you double that up, still doesn't mean that they're not going to have a lot of HP. I mean, can you imagine how long it will take you to take down a boss that has, like, 5 million, 10 million HP with this leader skill? Literally forever. So, not that viable. And again, the super attack, I don't understand. Not super attack, the passive, I really don't understand why they kind of went for that, but I mean, I haven't seen the stats yet. For all I know, that's going to be A1 when you actually mix it in with how much of an attack boost he gets when you put him in proper leader abilities. His links consist of strongest clan space, I can't speak, brutal beatdown, cold judgment, nightmare, big bad bosses, metamorphosis, and shadow limit, and he fits only in the movie bosses category, which again makes sense. So basically you have to run him under the agility cooler, not cooler, a turtles card that was released a couple months back, which I actually don't have yet, but that's going to be the card you want to run with. So, I mean, I don't know, it doesn't seem that great to me. I get it off the tops, but there might be some creative ways to actually use when it comes down to it. Overall though, like I said, are you going to grind for the World Tournament? I still don't know yet. I want the Great Saiyaman, but if it ends up being that I don't get top 5,000 or top 10,000, whatever the actual requirement is, I'm not going to be too worried about it. But I might try just because that Great Saiyaman is going to be A1. Cooler, I don't know about it yet. With that said, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what you guys think about the brand new LR, Perfect Cell, and the Cell Juniors. And also while I'm at it, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below, what the next LR that you want to see. To those who said LR Cell is coming next in my last LR news video, like what, a month ago, congrats, you were right. But let me see who can call it next, so let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. what you think is going to be the next LR coming out over the course of the next month or so. Usually they release them like once a month or so. With that said, if you have any other further questions, you can tweet me at Rhymestyle. You can also leave me a comment down below. And better yet, if you have any deeper team composition questions or translation stuff, you can also refer to the subreddit link in the description below. But other than that, keep your eye open for Cell 7 videos later this week, and of course a duel against Nano as well. And we'll see where we're going to go over the course of the next couple days. I'm excited. Let me know your thoughts down below. Leave a like if you enjoyed today's video. And I guess I'll see you guys in the 7 videos tomorrow. Peace.